filing software from shops, like the ones after coffee shops. Berkeley, California becomes the first city in the nation to charge people for using them. If your cup is not reusable or compostable, you'll be charged 25 cents on your bill.
And when it comes to the weather today, what you need to know headed out the door, there is a little bit of moisture with the boundary pushing through. So although we have more consistent snow showers up closer to the North Shore, St. Cloud right now getting a mixed bag of a few flurries along with some light rain showers. And that'll be continuing to push down into the rest of Sherburne County over into Anoka County. There are a few rain showers showing up on radar for Anoka into Washington County and up along 35 north of the city as well. That'll all continue to impact areas if you're traveling north or into western Wisconsin, into Polk County as well. Hour by hour here in the Twin Cities, through about noon, we have a chance for a few of those sprinkles or flurries to push their way through. Overall, though, it's just cloudy. You can cross your fingers for a peak of sunshine later in the day. Dress for the 20s today as we aim for a high officially of 35 here in the metro. And then looking at the 7-day forecast, some light showers early tomorrow morning.
All right, and a big backup just popped up here along Eden Prairie Highway 212 at Shady Oak Road. They just turned the camera, so you can't see it right now. But if you go to my Twitter, I just posted a photo of this large backup in that area. So go to Twitter and find that. I can assure you it is a big one. Chris.
That's the rush out. Remember, you can follow us on social media for news updates throughout the day. Now to a story worth being late to work for. Have you heard of this? A social media movement called Tip the Bill Challenge. It encourages diners to leave 100% gratuity. Some have gone much higher. A waitress in Michigan got a $20,000 tip on her $23 bill.
$2,000.
Is that what it said? I don't know. It says $20,000 here.
Huh. Either way.
Hey.
Either way, it's big.
Yeah, it's
right?
large.
Either
right.
way.
She's a single mom. She's a recovering addict. Was homeless a year ago, so that's all just a good thing to add.
Yeah, so we're all encouraged to put a little more on our tip. Whether or not you go to those extremes is another question.
For sure.
But that's a good bonus for her. Hey, Facebook Live, we're on right now. Show of the year.
I know, right?
One of many.
We got the day off yesterday.
So
we're refreshed.
Fun.
We're back. It's 2020.
Yeah, lots to talk about yesterday. Yes. I mean, other than, coming down from your New Year's celebrations, what did you guys do?
I slept all day because I'm getting over a cold.
Yeah.
I took down Christmas decorations.
Oh, yeah, you got yours
at
down.
At least some of them, yeah.
You like to start the
watched
new year.
Watched a lot of football.
Yeah, football. Yeah, watched that Gophers,
Gophers
game. That was excellent. I mean, also, the Badgers were playing in the Rose Bowl. That did turn out
yeah,
so well.
Exciting. That you got to, I mean, I'm happy it was an exciting game and all the feels were there, but then just the end.
Well, let's stick to the positives and the Gophers' victory because it was awesome.
That's awesome.
Yeah. What was it? Their 11th win, first time since 1904 they'd done something like that. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's huge. So.
And another bowl victory title to add to their resume. I think they have 9 total now.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's a great game and it was one of those things, I mean, an upset victory, I guess you could call
True.
It. It was a good game, and the amount of fans that went down there was incredible.
Way more Minnesota fans than Auburn fans. I mean, even the Tampa natives were saying that. They're like, did the whole state of Minnesota come down here? Well, I don't blame them because it's so much warmer down there.
Yeah. We've got something to escape.
Versus those Auburn fans where they're just getting used to it. But
that's a good thing to like have a little vacation revolve around.
Right. You know?
Exactly.
So hopefully there'll be many more bowl games in the future there.
Yeah.
Are we going to share some comments about this? Anybody
I
know about
we
this?
We are.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, here we go. Ooh.
Hey, a little tease.
You know what? People are excited.
There we go. they're kind of switching around. But, yeah, I mean, so much excitement over this game yesterday. And what a testament to the program, the coaching, the students. And Tyler Johnson, was it? He's a Minnesota native. He led the team with 2 touchdowns yesterday.
Incredible
day. He's like the MVP. What a way to end your college career, right?
Yeah.
Caroline saying PJ Fleck and the entire team should be very proud of their win, of course. Let's see another comment here. Oh, row the boat. Look at that. We got our Gopher mascot there.
Working overtime.
And some more pictures there, too. So, yeah, that's great. You know, we caught up with PJ Fleck after he got off the airplane. Everybody was kind of like bleary-eyed because this has been a long day.
Yeah.
You know, lots of emotions. And so he said, I'm not resting. I got to hire some staff, and I've got to recruit more players because they had like 16 seniors on the team, I think, this year.
Yeah, there's no quitting him. He's already looking ahead. And that's what you need in a coach. I mean, you want to keep the program strong, and you got to, I mean, replenish those players every year. Mm-hmm. So he's got a few more scholarships probably to hand out, and we'll
for
see
sure.
where the team goes.
Yeah, it's exciting.
Are we talking about weather?
Uh-huh. Oh, let's talk about the Winter Classic.
Oh,
yeah, that's
yes.
right.
Yes.
You know,
yes. Okay, so I was excited to see this on Twitter yesterday. The 2021 NHL Winter Classic is coming to Minnesota at Target Field. The Wild are playing against a big question mark. They haven't announced it yet. This is video, I believe, from TCF Bank Stadium. I think a similar classic was, that was in like 2008. But it hasn't been at Target Field, I believe. So, again, New Year's Day next year. Ticket info has not been released yet, but I totally want to go.
Yeah, it would be fun. I mean,
as long as it's not like
yeah, frigid,
right.
Exactly. It's one of those things where, you know, for the fans, you have to have it relatively around the freezing mark. Like if it was on a day like today, it would be perfect.
It would be great. Right? Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah. That's something to look forward to.
It just makes such a big difference when you watch hockey outside. It really does. It's just the atmosphere. Mm-hmm. And
it's one of those fun things. So a lot of people were looking forward to that. I mean, a lot
of
people
were
just saying. And one guy didn't want them to play the Blackhawks. Why not? That's a big rivalry.
I know.
Yeah,
it would be good.
You want to win.
It's that's true. Yeah, we want the Wild.
There's
to win,
a but. Little mental problem that happens when we play the Blackhawks.
Can't beat Chicago.
Yeah,
that's unfortunate.
But that'll be fun.
Yeah. Well, we do one more thing to talk about before we get to the weather.
Okay.
The College Fund in St. Paul. You're talking
college
about this.
College Fund.
Well.
Okay. So yes, starting with the new year in St. Paul, basically every newborn who is born to, or every child who is born to a St. Paul resident. Gets $50 into a college savings account. And that's going to be funded by the state for the next 2 years. After that, it's going to be on like a donation and fundraising basis. A lot of people have been talking about this. I don't know if we're going to show some comments. A lot of people kind of divided on this. Sue says, this is an awful waste of money. These kids will end up with less than $50 due to the rate of inflation. Other people think it's a good idea. Joanne says that. She says, I think the parents are supposed to add to the savings account and make the $50 grow for a school account later. Yeah, I mean, the whole idea is it's a starting point.
Exactly.
This is not meant to, it's not meant to pay for their tuition.
Starting, as a parent, starting that account is half the battle. You know, and just like doing the work to start it. Now that they have it, it's easy to say, oh yeah, grandma and grandpa, you want to give a present? Donate to that account.
Yeah,
exactly.
That's
a good idea. Yeah.
It's a great way to fuel it.
It's the start of it, even, you know.
Well, and you know, as a parent, I mean, when you have a child, you have so many other things you're thinking about at that time.
Right, yeah.
Versus, let's set up an account.
For college,
right, you know?
20 years down the road. Yeah.
Exactly. So, yeah.
Okay, weather. This morning, we are right near that freezing mark, and that means that just a little bit of precipitation that's falling to the north is coming down as a mixed bag from rain and snow. We're seeing that push through St. Cloud and into Annandale, soon to be through Maple Lake and Monticello here through the rest of the morning, and a few light showers, both rain and snow, pushing through parts of the northeast metro right now and really all up along 35. So if your drive takes you really north of 94 this morning, you'll run into just a few sprinkles and flurries. We'll see a few of them over the next few hours in the Twin Cities, but overall it's just a cloudy day and mild temperatures. 35 degrees is our forecast, but dress for the 20s when we factor in just a little bit of wind. And then looking at the 7 day, our next bit of weather comes as some light snow showers tomorrow morning. That gives us about a half an inch, and a very similar situation for Sunday as well.
Okay,
just a quick shout out here from a couple of people watching. We have Deb in Faribault. She's a regular watcher. And I don't know how to say the name, but somebody's watching from Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia.
Oh, wow.
Nice.
So, wow, there we go. International on their first Facebook of 2020.
Happy New Year to you all.
Many more
Happy
to come.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow morning.